and time has slipped away, and suddenly it's hard to find the memories you left behind. Remember, do you remember the laughter and the tears, the shadows of misty yesteryears, the good times and the bad you've seen, and all the others in between? Remember, do you remember the times of your life? Will you remember the times of your life? Gather moments while you may, collect the dreams you dream today. Remember, will you remember the times of your life?
I would very much like to welcome Sonia, Stieg. We're all trying to find our tables. It isn't easy. I would like to welcome everybody today and very much thank everybody for coming downtown, because for a lot of us, it's not an easy trip to make. The city is a very tough place to get around unless you come down here on a regular basis. But we are here to help anybody that needs to get back to their cars. I heard tonight, there's a man over there from California. We are here to help everybody get back to their cars. After that, everybody's on their own. Very good.
Sure, man.
Wooddale, as you can see, way out there is somewhere, but not far. This is a very special occasion for all of us, I'm sure. One of the things that has brought us all together, of course, is the communication that my mom has been able to pass on to all of us. And the kind of person she is, she is a very good communicator. And by communicating, I mean there's several things that go along with communicating. One of which is she has a tremendous compassion for listening and understanding to people's problems that occur throughout their lives, because one time or another people talk to them about their problems, and she always has listened and taken a very understanding position. I think this is a very good, remarkable point about her. Also, her tremendous love that she generates to all of us, sometimes not always, as her son, I can say that because she's taking the other role, but she is a very, very loving person that has always presented that same feeling and generated it. And the third and final thing that I think is so important is that she has always kept such a very positive, warm attitude that she generates to all. Every time you're around her, she generates that kind of an attitude, and thereby passing that on to all of us, and we all then hopefully pick up on it and pass that on to the people we're associated with day in and day out. And for that reason, I think we should propose a toast tonight to a lady that has generated so much warmth and kindness, and in this little bit of time we're all together tonight, I think that this, we're all here to give her back just a little bit of what she has given out to everybody for 75 years. And I'm sorry, but that's 75 years young now, not 75 years old. And really, so with that, I'm going to get my glass, and everybody get their glass and stand, if you would, please. Mom, from all of us to you, God bless you and God be with you always, because we all love you. And happy, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jeanette. Happy birthday to you.
With that, we're going to all sit back down, please. And
we can sit now?
Yes, sir. I really mean that about the parking. We want to make sure everybody gets back in their cars. Because this bubbly has been so good. It's very important that we all get back safely, but Everybody is to relax and enjoy themselves, and this is the kind of party where we all want to have a good time. Thank you very much.
As good as ours.
And we've been friends for so many years. Happy, happy birthday.
Many more birthdays.
And many more.
Say something.
Thank you.
love it.
Graphite textiles, we had those in Vietnam, and we had 47 of them, and I'd say at any given time, over half of them were out of commission, because the Range Fighters Army and the Army didn't have very
much. Happy birthday,
Anthony. The Air Force and Navy was in 30.
Those of you who don't know me, my name is Ralph, and probably the last time you saw me, I was a little fella. I've grown up as kids. He really has. You know, Alan, he didn't have much potential in the beginning. Well, I have to admit that. I went to visit him, you know, when he first got married. And he was in California. I guess that's where you were, Alan, right?
Yeah,
and boy, I said to Lil, golly, I don't know about that boy. He's going to have a hard time. But, you know, he's done fine. Alan, you know, you and all your brothers and sisters can be commended for doing a good job in life. And Jeanette, I'm sure, is mainly responsible for